Good morning, Carlisle Eagles. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now for our Eagle Swag Pledge. Please repeat after me. I will soar safely in everything I do. I will work together respectfully. I will accept responsibility for my actions. I will allow my teachers to guide me towards excellence. Eagle swag is what I do. You may be seated.
We going. My pants poster sag. We going ultra. We going ultra black. I got a toast to that. We don't fold the crack. We going. Occasion we rose to that, going postal. We going ultra black, watching the global change. Hopping the coldest range, hit boy on the beat, this poster slap. We going ultra black, we going. Rhythm and blues, pop rock, soul to jazz, till my toes attack. How I look being told, I'm not supposed to brag. Nobody fault, I tell the truth, I know it's facts. We ultra black, gray stone, skin tone, but multi that. Multiple colors, we coming all shades, mocha black. Except where I'm at and I fight me on it. Emotional stares like I might be wanted. Pitch black like the night, I'm ultra black. Sand for the sun, reruns, jokes are black. Oh yes, God bless success. We going ultra black, like the S is fast. Talk with a mask on, the freshest breath. African black soap, caress the flesh. Super fly the Mac, sitting fly in the lac. Take a boat on the water, history talks with my daughter. My son will be my resurrection. Constantly learning lessons. I never die, you get the message. I hope you be better than I. Life's precious. Two-stepping. Sometimes I'm over black. Even my clothes are black. Cash money with the white tee and the soldier rag. We going ultra black. Unapologetically black. The opposite of Doja Cat. Michael Black's in black. We going ultra black. I got a toast to that. We don't fold the crack. Occasion we rose to that, going postal. We going ultra black, watching the global change, hopping the coldest range. Hit boy on the beat, the poster slap. We going ultra black. We going ultra black. Raiders Oakland hat, I smoke to that. Pre-rose and yak, what's the results to that? See notes and bags. She knows I'm classy like I'm Billy D. Williams. Go ultra black. Isaac Kennedy films, penitentiary too. Black like out in the loop. Black don't crack, it's like the fountain of youth. The coach is black, like Iman, she beautiful. Going ultra black. To Africa, you say go back. I stay pro-black, my Amex black. Black like cornrows, afros. Black like hat, black ball from the Super Bowl. Collin, holler notes, I can't go for that. Motown Museum, Detroit, I'm ultra black. This for New York and all of map. No matter your race, to me we all are black. We going ultra black, I got a toast to that. We don't fold the crack.
If you're a movie fan, you may recognize the name Bryan Stevenson as the hero of the 2019 movie Just Mercy, played by Michael B. Jordan. It's the true story of a Harvard-trained lawyer who saves an innocent black man from execution in Alabama.
If we're just going to accept the system that treats you better, if you're rich and guilty, then if you're poor and innocent, then we can't claim to be just.
Mr. Stevenson.
Mr. Chief Justice, and may it please the court.
If you're a Supreme Court justice, you may remember when Bryan Stevenson convinced you to impose a ban on life sentences for children. And if you're a visitor to Montgomery, Alabama, the name Bryan Stevenson is everywhere. His nonprofit, the Equal Justice Initiative, created this memorial to the 4,400 victims of lynchings in America.
Each of these monuments represents a county where lynchings took place.
It's called the National Memorial for Peace and Justice. Its pathway leads you around a big square, angling steadily downward.
They start out looking like tombstones or coffins,
And by the time we're here, they're like hanging bodies.
Yeah, yeah.
Stevenson grew up in the poor rural South, great-grandson of an enslaved man. He attended Eastern University on scholarship and wound up at Harvard Law School. But an internship in Georgia changed his life.
That was the first time I met a condemned prisoner. It's when I learned that people in this country were literally dying for legal assistance.
But you were a Harvard Law graduate. Did nobody say to you, dude, you could make a lot more money going into a law firm?
It seemed like everybody said to me, you should be making a lot more money. But I don't know that I would be passionate. And I saw this community, and I think I just knew that I'd be engaged.
In his 2014 memoir, Just Mercy, Stevenson describes his first meeting with the condemned man. Those bigger issues are obvious in his latest achievement, a 40,000 square foot museum that traces the entire history of American racism. It begins with the abduction of Africans.
12 million Africans kidnapped, abducted across that ocean. Nearly 2 million died during the journey.
And the story of slavery.
I wish I could hold those children. I want to let them know that God will take care of them.
So these aren't playwright words.
No. There are hundreds of what they call slave narratives that we went through. Each one represents a lynching that took place in America where community members have gone to the lynching site and dug soil from that site. But we can be more than a country of enslavers and lynchers and segregators and executioners, but only if we acknowledge that.
And that, he says, is the point of all of this, to confront our unpleasant history as a first step in healing.
Some people are like, oh, I'm afraid to deal with the truth because I don't know what I'll feel. I don't want to punish America for this history. I want to liberate us. I want us to get to something better. But to get there, we're going to have to talk more honestly about the barriers we constructed over 400 years.
What's striking about Stevenson's offices, memorial, and museum is that they all sit on the very streets where black people once arrived in chains.
I think it's really important that we tell these stories in ways that are authentic and represent the power of place. I mean, a lot of people have said, your national memorial is really powerful. You just should have put that in Washington. I want people to come to Montgomery.
Since the case described in the movie, Brian Stevenson has helped to save 145 wrongly convicted prisoners from execution. But he'll tell you that his work is far from finished. From the outside, it seems like your work generally falls into two categories. There's all this, which is education about the past, lynchings and slavery. And then there's your real job, which is representing people who've been unfairly incarcerated. Is there a connection between slavery then and incarceration now?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, we have the most punitive society on the planet. We tolerate excessive punishment that very few societies tolerate. And that's largely because we have been acculturated to accept extreme punishment, beginning with enslavement, beginning with lethal violence and lynchings. History will help us recognize is that this stuff is connected. It's all connected. You know, for me, it's all one job, and the job is justice.